In this lesson, we'll learn how to split the data. First, we have the training data. This is the data that we use to train a model. Secondly, we have validation data. This data is used to select a model. Third, we have the test data. This is the data we use to report the performance of a model. Now, a training error is used to tune the performance of the model on the training set. A validation error is used to select the model that works best among many models. We then use the test error to calculate the performance of the model that we have already selected. In the next few videos, we will introduce each of these errors and how we use them to make the decision to eventually use a specific model to solve our problem and to identify cars in the connected cars dataset. There are no general rules how best one should split the data for each of the three purposes. Depending on the size or the volume of the dataset, one will decide to split in proportion of 50 for training, 25 to validate, and 25 to test. Often one might need more for training or validation. There are also constraints from the model itself and the complexity at which we build the model. We will talk about model complexity shortly. It is important to note that the test data needs to be set aside until a particular validated model has been selected. This gives us an unbiased estimate of the performance of the model. More specifically, when we are building the model, we do not examine the test data at all. This is to avoid biasing our results on the test set. This is an essential part of the validation process.